Hello, I will be giving you instructions for the new Muddy Obstacle course. This course is completely different from the course in the past, so I advise that you listen up, pay attention for the rules and tips. Your whole team will be on the muddy side of the course. There's an A side and there's a B side. The time for your team will start when the whistle is blown. Remember, your team is not done until you complete all of the elements. That means all teammates must make it through all of the elements. Remember, use teamwork, cooperation, and trust to help you get through this course. It is very tough and it will require all of this. So make sure you help your teammates. First element your team will do is an army crawl, wall, over and under, slides, catwalk, and crawl tunnels. The time will stop after your team finishes the crawl tunnels. The first element that the Muddy team will do is the army crawl. See, you're only allowed to go in one by one. You may enter once your teammate has fully crawled into the pit. You're not allowed to stand up. There will be ropes covering the top of the pit. Once all of your teammates are out of the pit, you will then be allowed to start the wall. After completing the army crawl, the Muddy team will move on to the team wall. This wall is 10 foot high. It is a lot tougher than the wall in the past. It will require a lot of cooperation. It also has about 2 feet of mud in the pit. The only difference from this wall and the wall on the ball field and other walls you may have encountered is that the last two people on this element will be allowed to use a rope that will be thrown over from the backside of the wall. They do not have to use the rope. They are only encouraged and allowed to. Now, when going up the wall, you need to ensure that you spot. Also, when you're at the top, make sure that you are helping to assist people up and over the wall. Also, make sure your feet are planted on the ground. Do not lean over the top side of the wall. Remember, safety is key. On the wall, the last two people do not actually have to go up the wall. All you have to do, it's the same way you came in the pit, you exit the pit, you go around the curve, and you link up with your team. But the last two people do not have to go up the wall. So that means as soon as you're done pushing the people up, you can go ahead and come around the wall. Remember, spot your teammates. Stand straight up, lock your knees, allow your teammates to push you up the wall. Do not just try to climb it. You will slip. Use your teammates. After completing the wall, the Muddy team will round the curve to continue on to the over and under. Remember, you will not be allowed to start the next element until all of your teammates have completed the over and under element. That means that the last person must go under the last pole, come out of the pit before you're allowed to move on to the slides. Remember, this course is centered around teamwork, so wait on your teammates. When you enter the pit, you will go over the first pipe, under the next pipe, alternating each pipe until you reach the last pipe. You will end up going under the last pipe. The playground slide element is the next element after the over and under. It is a lot tougher than advertised. You will really have to physically help your teammates up and down the slide. Now, when you reach the top of the slide, it is solely your decision on whether you decide to go up, go down head first or feet first. Keep in mind that the last person will not have any help from the bottom. You are allowed to use the top of the platform and the slides to assist you in going up and over. After you have completed the slide element as an individual, you are not allowed to come back around and help. You must exit the pit. You will stand on the outside of the pit waiting for your last teammate to get over the slide. The only exception to that rule is that one person may come around and help the last person. So after the next to the last person goes up and down the slide, one person can enter back into the pit, come around your designated side, and help the last person to get over. The element that you're going to do after you complete the slides is the catwalk. Now remember, you have to round the curve before you actually start the catwalk. Your teammates must all be through the slides before you're actually able to start the catwalk. The catwalk, your teammates must be interlocked facing opposite directions. So the first one will go on facing towards the right. Second one goes on facing towards the left. You must remain interlocked and your team must traverse the pipe facing sideways as you see on the video. Now, if one of your teammates or if multiple teammates fall off of the pipe, you must get back on where you are, wait for your teammates to get back on, and then continue on. You are not allowed to continue to move until all your teammates are on the pipe. Okay. Next thing, let's say one person gets off of the pipe and they're done. Okay. The entire team, okay, must stay interlinked even though that person is actually off the pipe onto the ground. You stay interlinked until all of your teammates are off of the pipe. After completing the catwalk, the Muddy team move on to their final element, which is the tunnel crawl. The tunnel crawl is as advertised. You crawl through the front side of the pipe and outside the back. After all of your teammates have crawled through the tunnels, you will then run across the finish line, which is where the time will actually stop. Be cognizant of the time. You are racing not only the other team, but the clock.